Ladies and gentlemen, if you would, if you have not signed in, please sign in at the back for us so we can have a record of your attendance. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll call this meeting to order. This is the February meeting for Valdosta Lowndes County Zoning Board of Appeals. For those of you that may have never been here, let me explain how we operate so you can keep up with us. I will call each case by case number and case name. Someone from staff will come to the lectern, give us the request, the information. Once it has been presented, there will probably be questions or discussions among board members to staff. Once we are satisfied that we understand what's being requested, I will ask if there is anyone here, either the applicant or somebody representing the applicant, that might want to come to the lectern and give us any additional information you feel like is necessary. Once we have listened to that, we will potentially have questions and discussions. I will then ask if there are any persons here in opposition, or if there's anyone here that has questions about what's being requested. Once we have heard that, then we will attempt to render a decision here today, which is a normal course of business. However, there is the rule in the bylaws that allows us to table, or the applicant may request table, if we feel like there is information lacking, no parties need to speak. Talk to each other. Work that thing out. Okay, first case we're going to call is VAR 20139-19 Lowndes County case. This is North Valdosta Church of God. This case, we have a letter from the applicant. He has lost a daughter to death, and he has requested that we postpone action until the March meeting. I get a motion. I have a motion from Mr. Orenstein, second from Ms. Gaston. All in favor, raise a hand. Unanimous. If you are here concerning the North Valdosta Church of God case, there will be nothing transacted here today. We will hear it the first Tuesday in March. Next case is VAR 2013-20, Lowndes County. Charlie Clark, on behalf of Valdosta Flag Foods. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, members of the board. Don't have a PowerPoint presentation with me today, so.
Oh, come on now.
I mean, sorry. But this is a carryover from last month. This was an opportunity to allow staff to re-advertise the variance request. There was two added variances, and we've done so. We posted the property, we sent letters to all the adjacent property owners, so hopefully we take care of everything in form of public notification. But the request for you today is for four variances, and if you don't mind, I'll just take each one of them one by one, and you can follow along with me in the packet I did present, put that in front of you. But the project itself is a combination of demolition, redevelopment, acquisition of additional property. So I'll try to keep this as simple as possible. The first variance is to the setback requirement. The area you see highlighted in orange will be considered the property side yard, side yard requirement. The requirement is for the building to be 20 feet from the property line, and their proposed convenience store is going to encroach upon that setback. On one end, it's going to encroach about 15.96, and on the other end, it encroaches 5 feet. We tried to work with the applicant to try to either realign the building, turn it a different way, but that was just too much for them to consider. So that's the first variance before you. The second variance is to the area highlighted in green. That will be to the Rock and Rodeo's property. There is a proposed property line that's being established that will require or which will allow result in the building encroaching on the required 20-foot side yard setback. The building as it sits is going to be 4.81 feet from the property line, so a variance of 15.19 feet is being requested there. The third variance is highlighted in yellow. The new property line will result in the building being about 1.85 feet from the property line, and the requirement is 20 feet. And we tried to, you know, work with the applicant, you know, and try to realign that property line or just design it in a way that, you know, it wouldn't be as close. The building official did inform us that however close the building is to each property line, they will have to meet building code requirements as far as fire rating and such. So with that, you know, staff will split on the vote of the recommendation. There was a recommendation for all three variances of denial, 5-2 vote. And there was some debate and some conversation concerning the recommendation. Some staff felt that as long as all the buildings could be done in such a way to meet the building codes, such as the condominium. You know how a lot of times a condominium concept, there is a property line that splits two tenant spaces, but it has to be fire rated. Somehow staff felt that this, you know, as long as the fire rating and the separation is satisfied, they didn't have a problem. Other staff felt that this was self-imposed. We just felt that, you know, the building could be a little smaller or shifted, or something could be done to, you know, eliminate some of these variances. So that's the reason for the split vote. And lastly, the last variance is to the county's overlay district, which requires lots to be a minimum of 250 feet. This requirement only affects the Rock and Rodeo's parcel to the south. They're really close. They are proposing a lot width of 231 feet, so staff has made a recommendation of approval because we felt that they were close enough to meet the intent and purpose of the requirements. So with that said, I'll be more than happy to answer any questions. There was quite a bit of debate on this case. I believe the applicant's representatives are here to answer any questions.
Okay, just to be clear, the variance of 15.19 feet side variance, that's something that your staff don't like to respond?
No, we recommend denial.
Okay, and also too, did the applicant discuss with you the reason why they couldn't make the modification?
They had devoted so much time designing, developing the building. The engineers here, and probably to answer that question better than I can, but they worked quite a bit of time with this project and in negotiation with the property to the south. It's been a long road.
The biggest thing, if all of the properties that are touching the various areas are upgraded to meet all of the fire regulations, then engineering would not oppose it as much.
That's correct. Staff
still says no, but engineering says we don't have a problem. if they are going to meet all of the codes as if it was a zero lot.
That is correct. And I would also like to mention, in the report, you know, the surveyor had, if you look at that last sheet, there was a proposal to combine, particularly the lot highlighted in pink, to combine the four parcels as one. We were concerned about not placing a condition on that, so they may want to design it another way, but as long as there is a total number of two lots, staff, you know, we're not particular that it satisfies what you see. You know, that lot line may want to shift somewhat, but as long as there is a total two lots, we were okay with that. But we were reluctant to put that as a condition or conditions to this particular survey.
Okay, and as part of this, they did do away with the request for the northern side yard setback. They moved the building to meet current readings.
They shifted that building in such a way they still need some relief, but we as staff can grant an administrative waiver without coming before you all. So they decided to go that route, shift the building down a foot,
still request the variances to the side yard. Any other questions? Any discussion from the board at this time for Carmella? Carmella, if you would have a seat just a moment. Is anyone here representing the applicant, or would you like to come forward and give us any additional information?
Charlie Clark with EMC Engineering. I feel like I'll probably be some questions some other way. Come on up. But we represent the applicant Flash Foods. Mrs. Pam Ringos is also here. She has a letter. She represents Ms. Edward Walker, who is the property owner to the south, and also is the seller of some of the property that Flash Foods is looking to acquire. So if you've got questions on their side, she can agree to represent this as well.
Any other
questions? Why can you make the modifications? Make it smaller?
Well, our client is Flash Foods, and they have different store layouts that are their standard. And of course, it's based on the equipment they have, it's based on ADA requirements, and the restroom as well as their retail area. And they've got the standards that they use and the equipment that they use throughout their corporation and all the different locations. And because of that, they could not design a unique building footprint for this site.
So all Flash Foods across America are all the same?
Yes, ma'am, at this point, when they are rebuilding, they're rebuilding to the same building footprint.
Any other questions? Any other discussion?
I have a question. I'm sorry, because I think that you all talked about this last month when I wasn't here. But right now there's a gas station on the corner, and right next to it is a rock and rodeo. And behind it is a piece of property that you're trying to acquire.
Correct.
And there's that's a liquor store.
And
the right now, Carmel, the rock and rodeo is within its property boundary. The one that you're talking about here is its.
It meets the.
It setback. Currently meets the setback.
Yes.
So how is it that it wouldn't meet the setback after this?
Because they're acquiring more property.
Okay. portion of this piece.
That's right.
Yes. But you're not getting, you're not buying this?
No.
From Allen?
What type of burden would be placed on Marcus?
I got that one.
Oh, yeah, if they're not, no longer in compliance. That's the reason for the variance, they need the variance in order for this, both of them need variances in order to make this project. If I answered your question.
Yes, it has Marcus, Lowndes requested it.
This is probably a representative. Both of them are tied.
They wait, it gets worse.
Exactly.
Question was from Quarterman that Rock and Rodeo, by selling this piece of property, now has created a situation that they are not in compliance, so they are having to partner with them to ask for these setback variances. And I think where Quarterman was going, and I may put words in his mouth, is Rock and Rodeo prepared to spend whatever money that is going to take to bring Rock and Rodeo up to code for fire-resistant walls and such as that because of this, because that could get expensive. And if they're not prepared to spend this money, then they may need to either oppose this or
have
it separated out or do something different.
Because you have competing interests.
From discussions with Ms. Pringles, they are in support of this and understand that it code requirements could affect their ability. They're in support of it. That's part of the landscape.
Okay. And if at some point in the future, in plan review or any other thing, and I'm directing this to you, Carmel, if something of this nature comes up and they start figuring what it's going to cost to do this, they do not have recourse to come back and ask for a variance to the building code because that is not a variance item. They have to meet building code.
That is correct. No, it's looking for the building issue, but that is correct.
And listen,
there is a construction board of appeals, but you know, certain code, building code, you can't. It's
a statute. I think that we can't grant a variance that lets the building be closer than 5 feet. Property line because that's in violation of the fire code.
You can. It's just that the closer the building gets to the property line, the more fire rating the structure has to be.
Listen, there's two reasons for the fire code. One is if you've got a property line, this building set 5 foot and this building set 5 foot, then there is a risk of one building catching on fire and the fire jumping 10 feet to the next. The other reason for that is because firefighters have to get between the buildings to fight that. But there are numerous, as Carmela said earlier, there's numerous places in Valdosta where it's a condominium type development, which means Dr. A owns this building and it's literally attached to Dr. B's building, literally attached to Dr. C's building.
Those are built
and
to
a certain
fire rating.
That's right.
Firewall between the
buildings. Right. Rock and Rodeo doesn't have a firewall.
Which is the question that I would say it is. They will have to retrofit their building to meet the fire codes, which could get expensive, which is why I was making sure before we jumped out into that and somehow construed that we created a situation that they got to spend money that they weren't prepared to.
You know, they have represented that they have this relationship, but do you have anything from Rock and Rodeo that evidences a request for a variance?
I don't, but I believe the representative has a letter.
And I mean, I think you need to look at, we need to look at the plan as it's presented and understand that this fuel island is plenty far enough away from the back of Rock and Rodeo, and as is the store itself, I think. So, I mean, it's not like they're proposing that they're going to build this convenience store 5 foot off the property line, therefore not allowing for firefighters to case of a fire, so, I mean, that's just my two cents. I mean, common sense tells me that there's plenty of access there, and they're willing to fire raid that wall, even though I think that would personally be overkill.
I can say that the fire inspector did look at the plan and was pretty comfortable with the fact that there's 16 feet between buildings.
The TRC, the fire official on the TRC.
Although he recommended denial, he was comfortable with the fact that there is some distance between those two buildings.
Well, not to jump, but while you and I are speaking, so Mike Fletcher. No comments from his perspective on the TRC?
County engineer recommendation was for approval.
So the whole DOT right-of-way, four-laning Norfolk Street extension at this point, there's no risk that the county's going to have to come back in and pay to purchase this building if they widen the road?
The way he answered that question was he was concerned, but he was not concerned because this is a long-term project. The way they acquire the right-of-way, they acquire it more to the north side where the church is, then there's no issue, you know, with them cutting off the corner of that.
So there is, as far as you know, there is plenty of room on the north side to acquire property for the right-of-way?
Yes, he didn't express any major concern.
I have a question for Mr. Clay. Flash Foods has gas and convenience stores on a variety of different sizes of properties. And so there's like one on Venus Road by the Harveys and it's on a pretty big piece of property, and then there's one on Ashley Street that's on a little smaller piece of property. So do they have different configurations of stores for different sizes of properties?
They do.
And this is a relatively small piece of property right here on the corner, but a super handy location. So do they have other convenience stores on a piece of property this small?
No, that I can't answer. I do not. But this is the smallest building footprint. As they rebuild, of course, there are older stores. They have older stores, and the existing store that's there, of course, is certainly much smaller. But they're looking to rebuild what their current stand is. And this is the smallest current building footprint. When they're upgrading, it would be this size or larger.
Any other questions or discussion? Is anyone here in opposition to this request? Does anyone here have a problem with what's being requested? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, any other discussions, anything we need to talk about before we try to come to a resolution of this issue?
Because of the fact that engineering recommended approval on the TRC, fire recommended approval on the TRC, and those seem to be the main.
Fire did not.
Okay.
Fire voted against it, but still had a reservation when they voted against it.
I still motion that we approve the request.
I have a motion on the floor from Mr. Orenstein to approve the four variances as requested and presented by staff. Is there a second? Motion fails for lack of a second. Can I get a different motion or another motion?
I motion that this variance be denied.
Second.
I have a motion on the floor from Dr. Housel. I have Dr. Housel, your motion is to deny all four variances. I have a motion from Dr. Housel to deny all four as presented. I have a second from Mr. Quarterman. All in favor, please raise a hand and hold them. All opposed? One, two, and abstain. Okay, we have a vote of 3-2-1. 3 in support, 2 in opposition. Do you need names or do you have them?
Can I have the two in opposition?
You have Scott and Bobby?
Okay.
And you have Matt that was abstaining. I was late. Okay, I'm sorry, it was denied. You can go back to the drawing board and bring us something. It is a different animal. We can look at it again, but we can't look at the same animal. Gotta have a different picture. Okay, the next case we'll hear is the City of Alhoffa case, application 2013-15, Mike Woolsey, 1328 North St. Augustine Road.
However, if ZBOA is so would consider, decides to consider the variance application, we would recommend that you approve it in the name of the two restaurants called Hurricane Bellow Wings and Denny's. That would leave it open to further evaluation should one of those move out in a new tenant move in. Any questions?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
So the applicant has contacted the hotels and the mobile station, but has not yet heard back from them, or they have said no?
I would defer to the applicant. I know he's in discussions, but I am not appraised of an official decision.
Okay. And your rationale for suggesting that it be only in the name of these two restaurants, we're going to go through the bother of tearing down the Denny's and building two brand new buildings. But then if one of them isn't viable as the thing it is, then that building sits there vacant right on our entryway. Why did you propose that?
Staff has concerns. Part of the reason that we recommended that is in discussion with the applicant, our understanding is that Hurricane Grill and Wings and Denny's have different peak hours, have different operating times. To kind of open the door to allow both of us to operate, albeit with less parking, we would recommend, that's why we recommended in the name of those two applicants on.
Because of their hours.
You are correct. Our concerns, if one was to Denal and another restaurant to work at it, we would be concerned that they would operate at similar hours that were reducing traffic.
Thank you.
Any other questions, any other discussion?
Just real quick, in the written explanation from the city, there seems to be a count of 66 existing spaces, but on the applicant's application, there seems to be a count of 67. Do we know, I'm just wondering, I don't mean to quibble over just one space, but do we know where that one space is, and is there an explanation for that, or is that just a miscount?
To our knowledge, that is a miscount.
Any other questions, discussion? Is anyone here representing, or is Mr. Woolsey here to give us any additional information?
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. Since we postponed this item, Michael Woolsey,
yeah.
Representing Remy Restaurants.
I needed that in the record.
And representing land owner, the entire portion. We're located in West Palm Beach. The condition that she's speaking about is reasonable. I don't have a problem yet. I do have an additional request for a condition if we're going forward with it. That being that these proposed shared parking agreement needs to be signed, executed, in the city's hand before a building permit would be issued for the second restaurant. Yes, I have been in contact with both landlords. Williams Hospitality Concern is here to represent themselves. We did do a site plan, 28 parking spaces on land that is currently underutilized. I won't say undeveloped, underutilized. It has some sprinkler equipment there. It has a small pump house, a landscaped vault, although it was rough landscaping, a landscape needed, or a fence area around it. There is of course you know that there are several signs there. So we site planned around the billboard sign, the identification signs for both of the hotels. We made an entrance through the area where there is a current flagpole, a lit flagpole. We will remove that, place that somewhere else, build that parking lot, take all of those appurtenances that are in there and make them secure and build 28 parking spaces. Again, with their approval, with a signed document, and whatever monetary issues that are with that, that has to be taken care of before both parties sign. Okay? That's pretty much where we are right now, is to sit down and negotiate parties. And I'm satisfied that we can satisfy that request of the landlord. On the mobile site, I was in contact with Hinton Oil. There's another corporate name for the land ownership of that, but it's basically owned and run by Hinton Oil. They made it asked a question that I hadn't thought of before, and really it pertains to both properties. With Hinton Oil, we did a site plan that was out of the radius of trucks traveling around the back to deliver supplies. Oil, food, etc. I think I saw a beer truck there this morning. So we site planned 18 there, sent that to Hinton Oil, and we spoke at length, I believe it was Friday, maybe it was Thursday, whatever day it was, representing Hinton Oil is Stephanie Hinton. And the question that she asked, or the problem that she posed, was that this property has potential of being redeveloped so that into a, as we're talking about conforming, non-conforming, I don't know how their property sits right now, but I know that when we built the new intersection with the traffic lane, there was a lot of concern about how the cars come in and out to the service islands. So if they were to redevelop, it would be an encumbrance, the lease for the extra parking space would be an encumbrance, and that they would have to break that lease or modify it or whatever. So that's the part that I'm saying is something that also equates to the Williams property. For example, if Georgia DOT comes through and does any kind of improvements and it needs right of way, it would more than likely come through that property. I think that's a pretty much a given. So knowing that those future agreements would be conditioned upon some future action that we don't have with Georgia DOT, we don't have any control with, probably with the Hinton, we have Hinton Oil, we probably have more control over, but it basically the same kind of issue. So we need an out in those things, okay? And again, that's why I don't have a problem with the Hurricane Grill being named on that building, because it could be, I seriously doubt if it would be another diner type operation, but it could be something that would conflict, and I understand that. With those numbers and whatever we decide, whether it's 66 or 67, okay, I believe that the number is 24, okay, in other words, 66 plus 28. 66 is what's on the property.